going on this rabbit hole of not really providing a definition or saying weird stuff about Wittgenstein. But whatever, I think that's kind of his basic view. But he also thinks that, sort of in the spirit of Wittgenstein, that whether moral language refers to something like objective in the world is, well, he's not going to be committed either way on that. May just be, it may not, but all the same as some language game or discourse we engage in for sort of instrumental or practical purposes. And so that's kind of his view, mostly. Does that make sense?
Well, parts of it do and parts don't. So when I asked him, what does it mean for something to be wrong? He said, well, it means it's bad. I said, what does it mean to be bad? He says,
yeah,
well, it means that it's morally impermissible. So that's I need to come up with a name for that, but that's like the net of like mutually referring meaningless terms kind of approach, which I profoundly hate, right? It's like you have to be able to actually somehow
just
connect.
Providing an underformative synonym, and it's like, I know.
Yeah, I mean, you have to be able to somehow connect it to a concept that I have, right? And he tried hilariously stupid strategies, right? Like, one of them that you would have probably laughed at was he tried to say, well, it's just going to be analytic, so I can't give you the concept. It's like, well, no, that doesn't make sense at all, right? Because you could have some kind of analytic relation, like synonymity is an analytic relation, and you can have a concept, an understanding of what the one relata is and not the other, right? And then once you're made aware of the synonymity relation, well, now you have a concept for the other relata, right? So saying it's analytic, as if, I mean, I don't know if he had directly said, therefore it's not informative, but this was an objection to me trying to get him to give me a concept, right? It's like, that doesn't work at all, because of course you can get me the concept, even if it's by providing an analytic relation to some other term I have a concept for, right? Like a synonymity, right? That's fine. So that's just moronic. And he tried another move of saying, well, wrong means, and you got some more clarity on this later, but I still have problems with this. Wrong means that it's contradictory if everyone accepts it. Right now that's vague. I forget if he said that or signed off when someone else said that. But there's like a few problems with that. So like the first is that when you say that it would be contradictory if everyone accepts it, what exactly do we mean by accepts it? Does that mean if everyone takes it to be moral? Because then we're just going to get like a regress problem, because the way you're defining the term has the undefined term in it, and it's just going to create an infinite regress. I'm sure you appreciate that problem right there.
Yeah.
And then the other, and I want your comment after, I just want to say the other too. The other is if you were to say everyone accepts it, which that's what, obviously what universalization is supposed to be, accepts it, maybe that means it, like everyone has a desire for it or something like this, something that I can understand, and at least I know what he would be meaning, then we'd have some kind of problem with showing what would the actual contradiction be, right? Now there are certain things that you can pull out where it's like, oh, if everyone desires this, you'd get a contradiction, but then we're just going to get that all he's saying is that it's going to be like Molyneux-esque, where it's like, you know, you just can't want the thing you don't want, or something like this. Like, you can't be that everyone wants to be raped, and really it's just because you can't, it's an individual person can't want to be raped, and the universalization, as Alex Malpass has pointed out, isn't even that relevant. All you're doing is like a kind of definitional sophistry move, where it's like, oh, the things that are wrong are the things that you don't, like, all he's saying is, you can't want the thing you don't want. So those are like kind of two pathways of objection. It's like, what does accept mean, right? Are we just creating an infinite regress because accept means takes it to be moral, and that's the thing we're looking for the definition of in the first place? And then the second one is like, what exactly is the contradiction supposed to be? And I suspect it would end up in Molyneux territory, where it's like, you know, it's not even, the universalization isn't even relevant. It's just like, You can't want things you don't want, like rape or something like this. It's definitionally unwanted.
Yeah, so I'm not sure exactly what he'd say about what the contradiction would be. It would have to be that people would are at the same time committed to wanting everyone to act in that way and not wanting everyone to act in that way. I guess you could get there if everyone accepted, or at least some people accepted, the maxim, you know, which is, you know, to perform some action only if you wouldn't mind it becoming some sort of universal law if everyone were to perform that action.
Well, he doesn't want to do that because that's about desires, right? He wants to say, when we talk about, so let's go to what you kind of cleared up when you were talking to him. You asked, so you're just saying something is immoral if it would be absurd if universalized, right? Like, that's the idea. And he said yes. Now, I asked in response to that, what do we mean by absurd? Do we just mean, like, everyone would have a desire against it? Because if the answer to that is yes, then now I understand what's being talked about. That's clear. I get the idea. But that's not what he meant, right? He said no, it's not about desires. This is where I got banned, right? I said, okay, well, are you saying that it would be contradictory if universalized? And he wouldn't give a clear answer. He couldn't get any kind of clear answer.
Well, he said, after you were banned, he said yes, it would be a contradiction, but he didn't elaborate on exactly what things would be contradictory, what propositions say would contradict each other.
Right.
Well, it was not quite clear. I mean, that's what we'd have to press him on if we were exploring that further.
Yeah, I mean, who the fuck knows what he would say to that? Contradictory if universalized. There's still that further problem about what we mean by universalized. Like, do we just mean everyone desires it, or do we mean everyone takes it to be moral? Because, or it's moral for everyone, if it's not about what they take it to be, if it's about, like, some, like, matter of fact, right? Because the whole thing is, like, if what's being universalized, if universalizing it just means something like it's moral for everyone, everyone takes it to be moral, something like this, we're still not getting an understanding of what the fuck moral actually means, right? Like, this is my whole problem with people who do the net of mutually referring meaningless terms kind of approach. It's like, you know, what the fuck are you talking about? And they try this obnoxious move, right? Jack might comment on this, actually, if I don't know if he's got his mic, but they try this obnoxious move of, like, well, I mean, it's just obvious. Like, I guess you just don't have this obvious concept that all the rest of us have. So it's like, fuck right off with that. Jack, that's kind of what you get from someone like Parfit, although I'm sure in a more sophisticated and less, like, irritating way, right?
Well, he doesn't, like, create a semantic circle.
No, I didn't mean the circle. Sorry, I don't mean to cut you off. I don't mean the circle. I just mean the what moral means. It's just a concept we all have. It's just obvious. And if you don't have it, I guess you just don't have the obvious thing. That's all I was referring to, not the circle.
I'm not sure he says it's obvious and we all have it. He just says, this is the concept that I'm talking about, which I think is what people, unlike Bernard Williams, are getting at when they talk about the moral, right, which is an external normative reason. A lot of people have expressed puzzlement about this, and it seems like nothing you say can get them to understand what you're talking about, so they just seem to be not in possession of the concept. It's not really like a problem of translation or something.
Yeah, I mean, I guess all I'm talking about is that when someone says that there's a concept they have, sorry, I shouldn't have said that everyone has, but there's a concept there, and I guess you just don't have the concept, and that's kind of like the end of the discussion. I was talking about that plus what's often added on, maybe not in the case of Parfit, but what I've seen added on tons of times when people take this approach, like INSUP or REM or, you know, whoever else, is in addition to, well, I guess you don't have the concept, it's like, It's more like, I guess you don't have the obvious concept that anyone could access if they thought about it for 2 seconds. It's kind of this, like, it's a response that makes it feel like they're saying, oh, you're kind of playing dumb. Like, everyone kind of knows what we're talking about. I guess I don't want to say everyone, but it's like, people can tell what we're talking about, and I guess you're just going to play dumb and act like you don't understand what we're all talking about. Okay, well, I guess if no one has anything else to say about that, I don't know, Troy, what's your, do you have any other comments about it?
Not really.
I guess there isn't that much to say when someone just, clearly displays complete stupidity like that, but sorry?
I was just gonna say, I don't know if, wait, is Jackson here?
Yeah.
I don't know if you were listening or if you heard him when he was talking about Wittgenstein, the beetle in the box, and relating that to moral wrongness. I mean, did you hear that part? Did you understand what he was trying to say?
That being alluded to by the time I came in, but I didn't know what had happened.
Yeah, I had no idea what he was. It seemed like a mess, but then he threw out the categorical comparative at the end. I'm like, oh, okay, there's something we can latch onto, and because you should have. And try to get make some progress on understanding your view. But the first part about the beat on the boxing, I just had no idea what he was saying, relating it to wrongness. It just made no sense to me.
I don't think you were the only person who was confused by that.
I would be surprised if I was.
Well, I mean, my confusion when he was doing this. Now, I don't know the details of the beetle in the box, but. Thing is, with Foot Soldier, you can never go off into the weeds. You, like, he'll just derail into the most ridiculous places, so you just need to say, look, I just want a clear answer to my question. So I wasn't going to humor him on the beetle in the box, but I take it as something about private language. We all have our own, you know, like, term or something. The beetle's like a term, and you don't, you can't, like, access what's in someone else's box or something like that. I don't know how the exact analogy's framed or the exact point that's making, but it's something to do with private language.
Yeah, but I was just going to say something in terms of not letting the conversation go into the weeds. I feel like I'm going to have to do the same thing with Jay Dyer, right? Because he can just ramble on about random shit. And
that's yeah, going to have to be. I guess you've done your Jay Dyer investigation now.
Is that today?
Yes, it is. 8 p.m. Yeah. Eastern.
8 p.m.? Oh, boy. I don't know if I can. I don't know if I'll be able to stand that. Wait, is it structured? Is it like?
No, I think it's just a free-form discussion.
I think I might. That might be easier for me to take if it's informal.
Because then you don't have to listen to him go for like 10 minutes at a time.
Yeah, because like with those structured, like when William Lane Craig has a debate, I just can't make it through a 10-minute statement. I have to like do something else.
Especially since when you hear for Craig, when you hear one of his opening statements, you kind of heard them all, right? It's just the same thing.
With Dyer, yes,
pre-Socratism kind of thing. If Garden of Eden was talking,
yeah, the best that I could do to try to make sure Troy doesn't get filibustered into oblivion is just. Request that Doobie mod it, which he said he couldn't, but he said he's gonna get a particularly fair mod. At least that's the vibe I got from him. So, you know, Troy, just make sure not to let, like, this is my only worry, okay? Like, you'll destroy him logically, but he might try to filibuster on you. So you just appeal to the mod if he can't get a word in.
Yeah.
One more thing, I mean, before, if we're gonna go on to Jay Dyer or something, with the beetle box and whatnot. So, it seemed like what he was trying to do was give the net of mutually referring meaningless terms, sort of construal of morality, and then when asked what a term means, try to invoke Wittgenstein and suggest that, like, well, it's well understood in philosophy that, like, someone really doesn't have to give any kind of clear meaning here. And it's like, well, just wait a sec. Like, I don't appreciate what you're doing there at all. Like, you just either can give me a concept or you can't give me a concept. And I'm just asking which it is. And it seemed like he just kept trying to say Beetlebox as a way to say, it's philosophically legitimate for me not to be able to give you a concept. And I wouldn't necessarily object to the notion that, like, you know, it's possible to have a situation where someone has a concept that you don't, and there's no way to convey it to them. But, I mean, you just kind of have to just clearly grant that you're at a complete loss to give the other person any kind of idea of what you're talking about. So, Troy, I guess I can put it as a question. You kind of understand what he was trying to do there. He was trying to invoke the Beetlebox to justify not being able to give any explanation of what it means to say that something is wrong.
Could be. You might be right. I'm not sure what his point was. That might have been. I suspect it might have been something else.
Really? It seemed to me like that's what he was trying to do there.
Yeah, I'm not. It could be, but it's not. I guess I could speculate on what else he might have been saying, but it's hard to say. I don't really know.
So I guess the bottom line would just be that he has not clarified what he means when he says that something is wrong. He's just given a net of mutually referring terms that don't appear to mean anything.
Well, except for the categorical comparative, right? Because he's given that.
Yeah.
But then we still have further questions about your contradiction or not. But that's at least something informative that we can understand.
Yeah, although it hasn't clarified what's meant by wrong. So it's like the first reply just makes no sense. The net of mutually referring meaningless terms, that just gets you nowhere. And then the next reply of, well, it's something that would be absurd if universalized. There's kind of two objections, and I just want to know if you would add more to this. So, like, the first objection is, what do you mean by if universalized, or if accepted, or whatever phrasing we want to use there? Are you just saying if everyone takes it to be moral, or if it's moral for everyone? Because if that's the kind of thing you mean, that creates the regress problem. We're just going to get the same, we're going to have the same question about the meaning of the word wrong or moral or whatever the moral term is, as we did in the original sentence, rape is wrong, with the follow-up sentence about what wrong means, which is something that would be absurd if it were wrong for everybody, right? So you I assume we all kind of agree on that. Like,
right,
that just pushes the question back a step.
If universalizing it means that everyone thinks it's moral or something, then you're going to get a regress. Yeah.
Yeah. If universalizing it means it's if universalizing it, however it's construed, invokes the term moral. Right. Like if it doesn't, if universalizing it just means everyone prefers it or something like that, then we won't have a regress problem. We can go in a different direction there. But if the definition of wrong just re-invokes the term that we don't know the meaning of, we just get a regress. That much is surely, like, straightforward.
Right.
Yeah, and then the other problem is when he says that it would be absurd, right? There's this further question of, what do you mean by that? Which he bitched out of the conversation. Well, no, the server did, actually. He was bitching out by refusing to answer, but then the server actually banned me for reaming him out for trying to sophist me on that. But it's not clear what he means by absurd. You say
he
that
did,
he must
he
mean
did
contradictory.
Say contradictory. He did say that explicitly.
Right.
Yeah.
Right, so...
But he didn't say and how so and which things were contradictory.
Right, okay, so... Big summation is just 3 points. Mutually referring term net gets you nowhere. Absurd if universalized. What does universalized mean? If that means moral for everyone or taken by everyone to be moral, we just have a regress problem. And then finally, what does absurd mean? Apparently what he means by that is contradictory. And in that case, what exactly is the contradiction supposed to be?
And I guess the further question would be, is this... his entire framework, is it a categorical imperative all there is to it, or are there other things, hypothetical imperatives and so forth, that might be part of the moral language game or whatever on his view? So
yeah.
Yeah.
Well, I took it to be a like a biconditional, like something is wrong if and only if. But yeah, I mean, he didn't. I don't know if he said that explicitly, so he definitely has weasel room on that.
Right.
But yeah, if, I mean, hypothetical imperatives. I don't think anyone's gonna object to that, right? I mean,
probably not. But he didn't talk about them at all. Sorry.
Right. It seems almost. I can only speculate, but it's like. It almost seems like he wants to make it seem like there's some, like... In fact, you know, I can only speculate. Those three criticisms are fine. What the fuck does this mutually referring net mean? Does universalized just reinvoke the term that we're asking for the definition of and create a regress problem? And assuming absurd means contradictory, what's the contradiction supposed to be? And then if you have a fourth question, you know, what, you know, is there anything else to what it means to be moral? Is there some inclusive disjunction of things it can mean, like either, you know, it's wrong if it hurt, it's absurd if universalized, or it's like a hypothetical imperative or something like that.
And of course there's always the more meta questions, like, well, why would we accept this view of moral discourse or whatever in the first place, like what is right. His reason for thinking that, but yeah, that's a more meta question, not really about understanding the view.
Yeah, I can't tolerate the guy. Of all the people I've met online, he is absolutely just like far and above the, by far and above, by far, I don't know, but he is the absolute worst sophist I have ever met in my entire life. Every time I talk to him, it turns into this, sorry?
Yeah, you finish the sentence, yeah.
I was just going to say, every time I talk to him, it turns into the exact same thing. I find some problem with what he's saying. And then once I push him on that, and he realizes, oh, like, ask yourselves pushing for an answer on that, he starts trying to dodge and weasel, and then I just keep asking until I get infuriated and yell at him, and he just keeps dodging, and then that's all there ever is to a conversation between me and him. He's just a dishonest, evasive piece of garbage.
Yeah, I don't remember him from, like, I guess I haven't seen much of him, but I do remember he was the guy who had those,
You cut out.
Ridiculous drawings or something about Name the Trade or something. Is that him?
Yep. Yeah. Yep. That's absolutely him.
Yeah. I remember thinking that was hilarious.
Yeah. He later conceded, actually, that the argument is sound, but he's trying a hilarious face-saving move, which is trying to assert, without any evidence whatsoever, that previously the argument was saying that objects are, like, fused together into impossible entities or something like this. He has no evidence for that, right? So he wants to say, oh, I accept its sound now that it's been revised in accordance with my criticism, right? Which he has no evidence for. This is just a claim he makes. But it wasn't sound before, right? He can't give any evidence that there ever was an argument that suggested that you can have, like, whatever the fuck weird contradiction he thinks you can have, like, something that has its history and doesn't have its history, like... It's just total garbage. So yeah, that's the kind of person you're dealing with. Like, when you show that he's wrong, he'll just dodge you, or he'll craft some crazy narrative, which apparently you can't give evidence for, that your view used to be something completely insane, but now that you've taken my criticism and changed your view, which I can't give any evidence for, well, now your view is okay, right? I mean, there's no one who annoys me as much as him, and it's because of the lack of humility, right? Like, he just cannot admit when he's wrong. He can't do it. And every time I talk to him, I mean, I'm not the fucking smartest person out there. I just come in and I try to be honest. I don't let him weasel. I just ask the clear questions. And every fucking time, it ends in him absolutely humiliating himself, being unable to answer. After being asked 23 times, what's the argument for P4? You fucking brain dead absolute idiot. Give me the argument, you fucking moron. Right? It's like, oh, it's a meta syllogism. It's like, okay, and is there an argument for P4? Well, you see, argument 14 has a conclusion of P. It's like, okay, but if there's another argument with the same conclusion, you can give that after. What's the argument for P4? Why would you ask for an argument for a premise in an argument? Who does that? Like, just idiocy of such a pure form that it's like, for someone like me, it's just kryptonite. It just drives me insane. I don't know what else I can say about it. It's just, he is the most evasive, dishonest piece of shit who I have ever encountered in my entire life. No one even comes close.
Why are you in that server to begin with? Why?
Because what? I got a message in my inbox saying Jack was debating him, and I knew that if that was actually the case, it would be a hilarious recording to capture of Vegan Foot Soldier just getting completely fucked in the ass. But it turns out that he didn't debate Jack for whatever. And then I just heard him arguing with Pogan, and he was saying some stupid shit. He was saying, you know, error theory can be true, and moral propositions, and a moral proposition like it's wrong to rape can be true, right? And it's like, okay, that's obviously a contradiction. But it became obvious after a while that he was just equivocating when he's using moral language. Like, when he's talking about,
right,
when he's calling that a moral proposition, and he's, the rape is wrong, and he's talking about moral propositions when describing error theory, the view that moral propositions have a truth value and it's false. He's just equivocating on what moral proposition means. So I ended up coming in to explain that, and then he seemed to agree with that, and Pogan seemed to agree with it, and then he started saying something about wrong, and then that's where the hilarious insanity of started. Yeah, that's why I was in there. Fuck that server, though.